Welcome to video 29 on flight sim navigation. We are still working on the radio and autopilot project. In the previous video, we created in MobiFlight the encoder to tune the NEV 1 MHz. In this video, we are going to add that we can, with the same encoder, tune the kilohertz. And then when we press this encoder, the switch will toggle between megahertz and kilohertz. So this is the challenge for this video. We are able, when we are ready to tune the megahertz portion, then press the button and then we tune the kilohertz portion. So this is what we will end up with the input section of MobiFlight, megahertz encoder, a toggle switch and a kilohertz encoder. Well, let's have a go. This is where we left off in MobiFlight in the previous video. We created this encoder for the megahertz portion of NEV 1. We are going to add the kilohertz portion, but we will be using the same encoder for that, so we don't need to add hardware, but we need to add the switch of the decoder, and that we had not done yet in the previous video. So we are going to extra settings and then find our MobiFlight tab and then the module that we are working on, and there we can see that we have only got encoder NAV1 megahertz. Oh, I called that megahertz. That's, well, in the previous video that was okay, but now we are going to use the same encoder also for kilohertz, so I better change that name. Let's take out the megahertz, it's just encoder NAV1. What I want to add now is the switch of encoder 1, and we had connected that to pin number 4. You can see that in the previous video. So let's add a device, a button, and pin 4, it automatically selected that because it's just increasing the numbers. And this is the button. Should I call it a button or an encoder switch? Well, I think I'm going with encoder switch. Encoder NAV1 switch. I do that because then if it is sorted in alphabetical order, the switch will be close to the NAV1 encoder itself. Okay, so this is done. Let's upload it. And do we want that? Yes, we want that. It is uploading right now. The upload is finished and we are done. I am going to save this file and say this is my file video 29. Yeah, I already have that, so, but because I prepared this in advance a little. So it's saved and we are done with the hardware. We now have an encoder NAV1 and an encoder NAV1 switch. That is okay. Let's work on the inputs now. The encoder NAV1 megahertz. Well, I just renamed that encoder. So we better look if that name came in here also. Yeah, encoder NAV1. So that's okay. I'm not going to change anything. We have NAV1 radio whole decrement and increment. So what we are going to do is add an input, and this time it is going to be encoder NAV1 kilohertz, and we are going to use exactly exactly the same encoder for it, which I just renamed to encoder NAV1. And if I rotate left, well, we are going to look for the event that is called NAV1. Let me type NAV here, and this time we don't look for the NAV1 hole, but we look for the NAV1 fraction. Yeah, it's not called kilohertz, it's called fraction. Yeah, how do I know that? I didn't know that, but you just try to read what it says here, and then this looks like the best guess. NAV1 radio fraction decrement. Okay, that's what I want. And then use will activate the event ID over here, and I can press OK. No, I cannot press OK. I have to do the same for when I rotate right. Then we are going to find this ID called NAV1 increment, of course, fraction increment. Yeah. And we use that also, and now we are done. Well, so far so good. I can now rotate the encoder, and what we will see, I didn't make a short video of that. What we will see is when I rotate the encoder, both the megahertz and the kilohertz change at the same time. That is not what we want. We want now to include our toggle switch to make this change between kilohertz and megahertz. To do this, we are going to use this precondition that we have seen, this tab over here. We never used it so far, but now we are. We are going to create a memory location where we store a number, let's say just 0 or 1. When we press the button, we are going to change this number from 0 to 1 or back from 1 to 0. And then in the precondition, we are going to look at the number. If it is 0, we will make the kilohertz active. If it is 1, we will make the megahertz active. So let's first create this memory location. And luckily, FSUIPC has a range of memory locations available. It starts at number 66CO. That is a hexadecimal address. If you don't know what hexadecimal means, just Google it. There's enough info to find on that. We are going to create an FSUIPC memory location, which will change when we press the button. So I'm going to click over here to create it. Yes, I'm going to call it toggle NAV1 megahertz to kilohertz and back, of course. I'm going to activate it, and now we're going to actually create it. It is an input on our MobiFlight module, and the device that controls it is now our NAV1 switch. And what kind of input is it? This time we are going to use an FSUIPC offset, and the number, the first free number of a memory location is 66CO. Oh, that is a small C, maybe better do a large C. I don't know that if that matters, but let's just do it. Okay. And now the value, if we press the button, we want it to change from 0 to 1. So I'm going to use an if statement here. If dollar, the dollar means the current value, dollar is 0, then comma, then it has to become 1, and else, second comma, it has to become 0 again. Yeah, maybe this is abacadabra, but this is how it works. This is an if-then statement. If the current value is 0, we make it 1, else we make it 0. That is how this reads. Let me quickly press OK. Now, we do have this memory location, but we cannot use it yet. We also need to create an output which makes the memory location available to be read out. Are you still with me? I hope you are. Okay, so let's go to the output tab and create an output here. And double click over here. The name is going to be the same. Why not? Toggle NAV1 megahertz kilohertz. Let's activate it. And now let's create it, and we are not going to use a preset. We know the value. The value to read is 66CO. And that's all there is to it. No transform, everything okay. I can click OK. This output is available now with this name toggle NAV1. And we are going to use it now in the preconditions of our input. So let me go to megahertz. Let's say that the precondition here in this precondition tab, add a new one. The precondition is a config item, and the config to choose is the toggle nav 1 megahertz kilohertz that we just created. So I'm going to apply it now. No, I first have to tell it the value. Well, the megahertz, let's say if the memory location contains a 1, then we are tuning the megahertz. Apply. Did I apply it? Yes, I did apply it. Yeah, it is now stated over here in the top row. Let's go to the kilohertz toggle encoder now, the kilohertz encoder that's over here, and we are going to make the precondition, but now with the memory location being 0. Config item, select that toggle, and now if it is 0, I am going to use the kilohertz input. Yeah, it is stated over there. Okay, and now everything should be ready. I hope you were able to more or less follow the logic behind it. What we did is the switch is pressed. That changes a memory location from 0 to 1 or back from 1 to 0. We created an input for that, but we also created the output where we can read this value, and that output we used in the precondition. If it is a 1, we tune the megahertz. If it is a 0, we tune the kilohertz. That's what we did. Let's now see this in practice. Okay, Flight Sim is running again. The Arduino and FSUIPC both connected. Let's press the run button. And now, well, we should be able to tune the nav 1 megahertz as we were in the previous video. And yeah, that is working perfectly well. We can see over here that it is rotating. But now comes the trick. I'm going to push the encoder button. Yeah, I did it. And now we should be seeing that I'm tuning the kilohertz portion. Well, and that is doing perfectly well. Let me for fun push it again, and we should have been toggling back to megahertz. Yeah, well, I'm totally satisfied. This was it. Not sure what we are going to do in the next video, but we'll see.